Old Dominion University football once again making history. Ted Alexander, Andy Mishaw, first ever playoff game, and it was just crazy as always.
It sounded like a playoff game, that's for sure. This is about the loudest I've ever heard this building, and it was rocking for most of the day.
And it got awfully quiet after Norfolk State's very first play from scrimmage, a 98-yard touchdown pass from Chris Wally to Derek Demps that was some blown coverage and some Keystone Cop stuff.
It wasn't blown coverage necessarily, it's just after the catch was made, the two defenders ran into each other and they had a lot of people up in the box pressuring the quarterback. There's nobody behind them, so it's an easy touchdown.
So folks are thinking after Norfolk State goes up 7-0, we might be in trouble. But then Taylor Heinicke plays for Old Dominion. He had another great game and got off to the fast start.
Taylor Heinicke plays a lot for Old Dominion. He throws a lot of passes for Old Dominion. Wound up with, 269 yards on this day. It's one to Nick Mayers, and Nick Mayers had a pretty good day himself.
And maybe it's just an emotional thing, but when you come back immediately after you're scored a pond to tie the game, everybody relaxes a little bit, and then we can get to some football. And the Monarchs kept on rolling, turning over Norfolk State with Carvin Powell.
Carvin Powell, outstanding interception. I don't know how he got his hands to this ball. It's a 6'3" tight end that he sort of jumps over to make that catch. It's just a great play.
Short field, Monarchs cash in. Heinicke goes to Larry Pinkard, and suddenly, instead of being down 7-0, they're up 14-7, and the wheels are rolling.
Just a good route here by the receiver, Larry Pinkard. Just good, quick outcut. Good move by Heinicke to stay alive and get it to him.
Now, Chris Wally, the MEAC Offensive Player of the Year, only had 4 interceptions all season long, and he's intercepted for the second time in the first half, this one by Eric Lewis.
Lewis, it's a tipped ball. It's not a bad throw by Wally, but it gets tipped and it hangs in the air just long enough. Eric Lewis gets there. He goes to Wally World, gets the interception, second of the day, sets him up again.
You've been working that joke all week, haven't you?
I was waiting for it.
Then, in the second quarter, up 14-7, Heinicke goes 24 yards to Prentice Gill, who went up and looked like Kendall Gill of the Hornets, the NBA snag for 6.
Again, the coverage was there. The coverage was there all day for these NSU defenders. It just seemed like the throws were just perfect. Heinicke put it exactly where he had to put it. Just the outstanding one-handed grab from behind by Prentice Gill was just, that was impressive to watch.
Blocked field goal from the special teams. They did that twice on this particular day. You add the turnovers to the block kicks, and no wonder the Monarchs rose and rose to the occasion.
Yeah, 2 turnovers, 2 block kicks, but the biggest thing, the biggest number, 18 penalties for 135 yards for the Spartans. Some of this was crowd noise. They had a lot of false starts. They couldn't hear the snap count. Some of this was substitution errors, things that cannot happen when you get to this late in the season. I mean, this is your 12th game of the season. You can't have miscommunication on the sidelines over whether who's going to end the game or not. And some of that was judgment calls by the officials, but 135 yards in penalties, I don't care who you are, you're not going to be able to overcome that.
21-7 at the half in the third quarter. Monarchs come out, and Heinicke to Mayers once again, and it was 28-7. They'd add yet another Heinicke touchdown pass, this one to Gill for the second time, and it's 35 unanswered points.
Five touchdowns for Tyler Heinicke, 0 interceptions, 5-0. He's got 20 touchdowns to 1 interception on the year. That one was a Hail Mary, and he just keeps going. You just keep waiting for him to show some sign of being human, but he just doesn't. He just keeps going, throwing touchdowns, no picks, taking care of the ball, running the offense. Just looks good.
35-18 the final score. Not only do the Monarchs get to 10 wins for the first time ever, they're 10-2. They survive and advance to take on Georgia Southern in round 2 of the playoffs.
Georgia Southern, it's a triple option offense down there in that Southern Conference, and it's going to be a battle. It's going to be tough. We know what the triple option has done to Old Dominion. The last time we saw it was against Cal Poly, and they put up 50. This defense is better than that defense was last year. Question is, can they slow that triple option down enough, or can that triple option score enough to put up 35 points or more against this Old Dominion offense?
We shall see. That's why they play the games. Once again, Old Dominion over Norfolk State in the Battle of Mermaid City, 35-18 for Andy Mishaw. Ted Alexander for Monarch Media.